Welcome back to Wabble Mechanics. Thank you guys for watching and subscribing to the channel. In today's video guys, we'll be working here on a Dodge Journey, which is the same as Fiat Prima. Well, we will show you guys today how to remove and replace blend door actuator motor. Okay, we have a few motors that control the VAC, the ex-VAC system. This is the heater system, heater and climate control system. Now we have one motor that selects the mode, okay, that, let's say you want the fan, okay, to blow in the vents, the windshield or the feet. So you have one motor for that. Then you have one motor that controls the temperature on the right side for the passenger side, one on the driver side. So far three motors, right? And now we have a fourth one, guys. That fourth one is the one that is for the recirculation valve. Okay, recirculation is this one right here, the one that opens and closes for the air to come from the outside or from the inside. Now, let's start with the recirculation, guys. We'll explain how to remove and replace them. We'll show you what each one of them is. The procedures are pretty simple, guys, and you can check out the description of the video to see where we get our parts from. This is your motor right here for the recirculation valve. Super easy, okay. All we have to do, there is only two screws that you need to remove. Then you guys go to, okay, let me turn the camera this way a little bit so you can see. Okay, that motor down there, okay, let me see, we're trying to get a little bit of better light. Yep, right there. This is the one for the passenger temp control. Okay, and if you move it up and down, okay, you're going to see if yours is working or not. Check it out how ours is opening. Now you have identical like this motor on the other side for the driver controls, and you reach it on the other side. So we can show you how to do that. We have it on the video as well. This one, guys, right here, the big motor, this is the one that usually goes back. This is the one, okay, that is for the mode. This is one, the one that controls if the air is going to come out through the vents in the feed section, the vents in the dash, or the windshield. So this is the one, okay, that does all that stuff, guys. This is the one that most likely will go bad on your vehicle. How you guys disconnect those and remove them? Really easy, okay. All we have to do, okay, right here, there is a wire that you need to disconnect. Push in on the middle piece, pull it out, and you have only two bolts holding it in place. Okay, one there, one here. Remove it, pull it out. The trick about those is, after replacement, guys, sometimes you have to calibrate them. We have the video on the channel, okay, with MaxiSys, okay, with MaxiSys, how to calibrate those. So check it out, guys. It will be very helpful video. Hopefully, guys, the video will be helpful to some of you. Please hit that subscribe button for more videos and see you guys next time.